basically, I'm talking about representation of travellers and Roma in the media. And so, Caoimhe is my name. I've been working as an information worker at Caoimhe for 5 years in total, but I worked 10 years ago, and then I went away and came back. So I have had the benefit of having like over time to see kind of what changes may have been. So I'm just going to talk a little bit about what changes may be most in the last like 15 years. Some information about the representation of travellers in Roma media, and the impact of that on minorities, and then like what we'll be hoping for in the future. So that's kind of where I'm going to go with this. And so as I say, I think what I can say generally, compared to like 15 or 20 years ago, is that we do have a situation now where people in the media will approach us for traveller inclusion, for travellers to be included in various programming. So for example, that could be, say, a children's programme, and they contact us because they want traveller children to feature in the programme. So this happens across a variety of programmes. So that's very positive that travellers are included in like what would be like considered not necessarily, you know, traveller fora. So so that bit of mainstreaming is positive. And then also, you know, I think we've definitely moved on in terms of the terminology, say from like say previous generation, maybe would use the term itinerant in relation to travellers and things like that. But that's just really, you don't really see that anymore in the media. So so that's positive. And I just put in this slide here to kind of to show the importance of the media in relation to travellers and Roma. I don't know if anybody has any idea what that might be a picture of, that slide. If I said the travellers are the tiny sliver part of it.
Portion per population.
Exactly, yeah. So that's the percentage of travellers in the population. So there's like 40,000 travellers that we estimate in north and south. So that makes up less than 1% of the population. So it's tiny. But you know, I suppose the first point to make would be that if you're reading the papers, there's nearly a constant stream of stories on travellers, so like, I would consider there is like over-representation of travellers, generally speaking, in the media. So the other thing to mention is that because of this population, the kind of difference in population size, like most settled people wouldn't have actually met a traveller. So the actual, the opportunity for interface is quite small, so that most people in the majority population are depending on the media for their messages, for their information on travellers. So that's just something to bear in mind as well. The representation, that generally you can say, probably it's not a surprise to people, but what you can say generally is that the representation of travellers in the media really kind of fits into negative stereotyping. This would be the kind of classic racist stereotypes that maybe would be, say, attributed to blacks in America or other minority groups, that they're, you know, that they're dirty, violent, and criminal. And those are the main kind of negative stereotypes that you find in the media. There is a study that was done last year, actually, that was published in the, I have it here, it was published in the Irish Journal of Applied Social Studies. And it's a Turkish person actually into the study, and they look at the vocabulary that's used in relation to travellers, and they categorise it into four areas: crime, the legal system, which is kind of related, accommodation, which would obviously focus in and around like living conditions and poor living conditions, and then discrimination. And those are the four kind of main vocabulary areas that feature in the Irish newspapers in relation to interracial travellers. So I am focusing in on the kind of the press, the newspapers in this. So just in terms of stereotypes, I suppose it's interesting, you know, what's the issue with stereotypes? I mean, they're useful because obviously if you're trying to communicate with people, you know, you need categorization is important, and you need handles, and people need to be able to kind of manage information in a fast and efficient way that is meaningful. But the other side of it is that obviously stereotypes actually don't correlate with the reality of the situation. And the what we would say in terms of the types of race stereotypes, I've mentioned some of them previously, but there's also the opposite of the ones I just mentioned, which is, for example, the romantic notions of travellers. So the it says here, shows here how, you know, racist representation is often binary. So you have either the really bad traveller or the really good traveller. So you have the traveller who's a fantastic singer, wonderful, the traveller who can make anything with their hands, or, you know, the that type of romantic image that exists in relation to travellers and Roma. And then this also becomes this kind of, as you go down the list there, the strange and exotic character that would maybe gives rise to programs like, you know, Big Fat Gypsy Wedding, and those type of programs where we kind of become voyeurs of the strange and exotic life of the traveller and Roma community. So you have the kind of, as I say, the bad stereotype, the criminal, the violent, all that, and then you have the other kind of rose-coloured glasses type of stereotypes. And then if you don't fit into either of those, you know, you're deemed not really to be a real traveller. Or, you know, if you don't fit into the, they're very strong stereotypes. So that's the, so it's interesting that, you know, a positive stereotype can be nearly as damaging as a negative one, because each time you're just moving away from the idea of the reality of the situation. Just, you know, we're talking about codes, but this is the NUJ code of conduct where it talks about how, you know, race was to be mentioned when it's strictly relevant, you know, so when is it relevant, obviously, is the question then. And then this story, this other part of the code, which says that covering stories in relation to race need to be balanced and in context. So those are the kind of the three elements that I'm looking at. So, you know, when is ethnicity relevant in a story, balance and context. So, I mean, this becomes very relevant in crime reporting. Say, for example, there's a story where, you know, a person's ethnicity is just mentioned that has absolutely nothing to do with the situation. So I think it was on my previous file, but I had a story. It was a woman who was murdered in a house, and the reporter just mentions she was a member of the traveling community. So it's nothing to do with her address, nothing to do with her identity. It's kind of just an add-on that someone has decided to add in because they deem it appropriate to add it in. And in fact, it has absolutely nothing to do with the situation. But for the person reading the story, obviously it then just compounds various stereotypes that you have in relation to travelers, which is the ones I mentioned, criminal, violent, etc. The other representation that's quite strong in newspapers is this whole idea of the traveler gang, which is disturbing. And this is a story, as you can see from the Herald, and it's kind of interesting because there's actually two gangs, if you like, in this story, but the second gang is called a cartel, which I think is slightly more sophisticated than a gang. And you can see where in the, when it's mentioned in relation to the member of the gang being from the settler population, they use the name of the actual person, so the Kinahan cartel. But when you talk about the traveller gang, it's the feared traveller crime gang. It's a lot more vague. There is no traveller named, even as you can see in the second story, the traveller gang, the traveller gang, the traveller gang. As you go down the story, it continues like this. So, I mean, that's side by side, two gangs, and how they're treated differently in the media. So it's interesting, but if it was turned around the other way, I don't know how people would feel if it was said, like, you know, the feared settled gang, which I'm sure they are just as feared, you know, and we would kind of like, we would balk at that, you know. But so this, that would be the traveller's perspective on that, like, you know, they don't mention it when it's a separate person. don't mention the ethnicity. So that's sort of an example. This is another example here, the traveller gang or women's estate. And this is, like, there is no court case in this situation. In fact, there is no crime. It's literally a story with two anonymous sources, and they are saying that there is travellers involved in running the estate, but they're not named in the story. They're not verifiable. What they're talking about, you can't check it out because they don't have any sources. And then when you read down in the story, at the end, it says, one of the sources says, well, traditionally there were no problems with traveller families in the area, and it's a relatively recent development with the minority of them. So it's kind of like contradicting itself in the one story, but I mean, still from with the headline, you're still reading about a traffic gang. So this is very prevalent, I think, you know, at the moment. This is another situation, which is a county council report. So this would be a staple diet of reporting, you know, for newspapers. And basically, you know, reporters go into county council meetings, they listen to what people say, they take the quotes, they come back, they write a story, and there doesn't seem to be any sense of obligation of actually, you know, checking out a story or getting the other point of view, because once it's in, like, the council chamber, they seem to think that it's like the lawyer or something. But, you know, I think the time has gone when you can just, you know, give county councillors free rein in terms of what they say without any type of challenges. And I think this type of reporting can be really damaging. So here's a situation where a county councillor, I think it's in Donegal, you know, is calling for the army to be brought in to deal with travellers, which is an extreme situation, and which is over the top because we're talking about, like, people with weapons and etc. And he talks about the overstretched Gardaí, and you know, it's obviously, you know, inflaming kind of, you know, feelings in relation to travellers. And then as we go on in the story, at the end of the story, it's some minor offences have been reported, but no arrests have been made. So after all this, and the calls for the army and everything else, they actually say in the story there was very minor incidents. So, you know, if that's that kind of a situation, you know, I think the local traveller group, but this is based in Donegal, there is a local traveller group in Donegal, you know, some type of context for the situation, you know, travellers, you know, coming in, why are they there, what's the situation for those travellers, stuff like that. It's just, so I think that's the prevalent, I think the idea that you can go into a county council chamber and just basically repeat what the person is saying without any type of contextualization, I don't really think that's acceptable nowadays. So the question is, like, you know, if you're a traveller and you're reading all these stories in terms of travelling around in the media, you would start to think, oh my god, they had it in for us, you know? And the question is, like, a lot of the time, you know, I suppose you have to understand that it's not intentional. And I think, like, in a lot of publications, you can see that, because in one page, they might have a very negative story, I've seen this myself, and you go down to the features section, and they might have a very positive story, and it's in the one journal, in the one day. And it seems that, to me, that, like, within the media and within the different publications, there isn't really an overall kind of policy, you know, people haven't thought about it, it's just random, you know, it's a random story here, a random story there, and people aren't really, like, standing back and looking at the kind of bigger picture. So obviously journalists and reporters are dealing with time constraints, so, you know, you go home after your county council meeting and that if your deadline's got to be in and you've got to get it in, so it just goes. Then you've got, you know, I can't not do this story because my competitor is going to do it. So once it's out in the open kind of arena, you kind of have this obligation to follow up. And then obviously the idea as well with, you know, for journalists that it is very useful to be able to connect immediately with your reader, and you know what's going to resonate. I mean, most people who are working for a decent amount of time in the newspaper, they know who their readers are. They know immediately what's going to set them off, what's not going to set them off. They know what sells the newspaper, and, you know, so they can use the distance they have with travellers, I suppose, because, you know, creating a distance enables you to kind of use the stereotype more. because you don't have to deal with kind of the consequences as such. So that's part of the idea that like it's not intentional, but that doesn't mean to say it doesn't have a damaging effect, or you know, that it doesn't need to be, that people don't need to be more responsible. Talking about agenda setting, this is an advertisement for the program, the UK TV program, and you know, this was, I don't know what people think of this picture. I don't know what kind of message it might give to you if you saw that on a billboard or something. I don't know, what would it say to you about travellers, or does anybody have any ideas about that? It's a little boy. Would you say it's kind of like a, how would you describe that image? Yeah?
Very negative.
Very negative?
Not kind.
It's not kind because...
He's going to be a fatter. I mean, we wouldn't say that about people, and gypsy or what's that?
So it's the wording, gypsy, yeah. Okay.
Words, yeah, that have been used.
And what about the actual photograph of the boy?
It's kind of angry or something. It looks like he's squaring up for a fight or something.
Yeah, it's kind of got a scowl on his face.
He's going to be a potential thug in the future.
Excuse me?
A potential thug in the future.
Potential thug. All right, yeah. No, he does, you can see him, it's kind of... lip is out and he's like, it's basically aggressive was kind of how I describe it. But like, in fact, the photographer who, these were the four photographs that the photographer, you know, submitted to the program makers for that advertisement. So you can see like that the difference in the other photographs. So like up here we have a child who's kind of engaging with the child in a friendly embrace with, you know, football in the background, something that everybody can relate to. Similarly, in the other one, we've got smiling, happy faces. And then down on the left, we have like something about like, maybe, you know, living conditions you can see there. And then the photograph on the right-hand side, and you can see in the one that they used, how do I go back? Anyway, the child in the background is cut out of it. So it's very much focused in on the, as you say, so it's kind of, you know, it's constructed. It's, and you can see the overall impact of it. So this is, you know, obviously that is on purpose. And there was a lot of complaints about that, and the advertisement was taken down over in the UK. So there you go. So that's that one. This is another one where, like, you'd have to say, like, you know, couldn't have been done by accident, because this was the story in relation to the Roma children who were taken from the Roma families here, and they're covering it, and it's like, it's the Roma child is related to Madeline McCann, and all the emotion around that whole story in terms of that child, and about that child, and it's like, it wasn't even that person, it was nothing to do with that. I mean, it's just total kind of fabrication. In relation to it, and it's just to basically stir emotions, so people will go, what? I mean, it's very blatant in some situations, and then in other situations, you know, I think it's to do with, you know, and the constraints of the actual media as well. So I don't think, but as I say, there could be a positive story on the next page. So the whole thing is very random. That's my feeling on it anyway. This is just to show like the concern that international organizations have about representation of traveler role in the media. So that it is a concern, and that it does lead to basically, you know, physical and attacks, etc. I suppose the thing that I would say in relation to you know, stories containing negative stereotypes are in relation in the media is that, like, a lot of journalists would say, like, well, you know, they would treat their story as an individual story, which it is, but what they don't realise is the background and the whole kind of the level of negativity that exists in relation to travellers and Roma. So when they put their story out, for them it's just one story. It's not like, you know, it's not a big deal as such. And as far as the scale is concerned, I mean, they might get a bit of a wobble and then kind of go back into place. That may be the way that they look at it. But if the scale's already tipped and then you're adding story to story to story, it's just kind of going over more and more this way. So it's like it's part of a wave, and I really don't think journalists understand that. I don't think they don't see themselves as being part of the overall kind of phenomenon of the media, and they people in the media are often stereotyped themselves. But just to say, it's like that then. So for a traveller, you know, going out trying to score a goal after a spate of stories or whatever in the media, that it's like that. It's impossible. The goal is at the top of the left hand side here. It's just impossible to score. You really feel things are, you know, weighted against you. And the level of negativity in Ireland in relation to travellers, you can see there's just a study that was done in 2010, which is quite recent. But you know, one in five people, 20% of the population, don't believe the travellers should have Irish citizenship. So that's extreme. You know, it's 20%, it's one fifth. That is an increase in the figure in the previous survey that was done. So feeding into it, you know, if you can see yourself as kind of feeding into something like that, I think people would maybe, you know, have a bit more thought in relation to their stories. So in terms of like negative stereotypes, I mean, where's it going? Well, I mean, it can only go in one direction, and that is like increased fears in the settled community and worse relations between travellers and settled people. I mean, it's not going anywhere else. Nothing else is going to come of it except negative situation. So this is a quote from a UK Irish traveller, and he talks about, you know, there you can see the effect on self-confidence, self-image and self-esteem. And I think a lot of travellers, you know, feel that. They feel like personally when they read a story, they kind of like personally, you know, they can feel it emotionally. And then, you know, imagine if you're, you know, it's like imagining if you're an Irish person in the UK and there's, you know, some story about, well, I suppose if you take like kind of the terrorists and IRA days and all the rest of it, and you have to go in to school the next day and you've got a job or whatever, and you know you're going to have to deal with this when you go into work the next day, and you know people are going to be saying stuff to you, you know, and you're doing that day after day after day after day. I mean, it's just totally wearing. So I think, like, in terms of what can be done, I think the cultural awareness among media workers, I think, needs to be, you know, worked on. And I think internally there needs to be space within media organisations for people to able to look at their own views, reporters and editors, to be able to kind of see, like, what are the stereotypes that you have in relation to travellers and women, because we all have stereotypes of everybody, of all groups, and to be able to kind of raise your own awareness about that, and also to understand that the context for travellers and women, like, what are the barriers that travellers and women face, what is the situation in terms of economics, in terms of health, you know, what is the real situation out there for travellers and Roma? And then the other thing is for travellers and Roma and people from ethnic minorities to be members of the media, that's obviously important, for that to be taken on by media organisations. I mean, it was great there a couple of months ago when we had, I Am Traveller and the Traveller History Project on, and just to see a whole programme where, you know, it was just travellers speaking, and you know, it's fantastic. And just, I suppose in general, what we would hope for is that, and what we'll be working towards, is that, you know, you have a real representation of travellers, not something that's kind of made up, but one that, like, reflects the diversity of the community, because obviously there's, like, you know, there's rich travellers, poor travellers, disabled travellers, you know, travellers who like reading, travellers who like go to the films, travellers who are big into politics or, you know, interested in economics, etc. And for, you know, for travellers to be, if there is a political discussion, for travellers to be trying to be included in that, etc. And maybe rather than looking at travellers and Roma as the problem, looking at, like, well, what are the problems that travellers and Roma have, especially the ones that are created by the government, which is there normally to try and help ease life for people. So there you go, that's basically what I have to say. So I don't know if anybody has any questions or... Any comments people would like to make, or?